It's an element of our electoral system that takes many people by surprise. Unlike most countries across the Western world, here in Australia, you can cast your vote at the ballot box without providing any basic identification. And ahead of our looming federal election, the discussion around maintaining a free and fair democratic process has never been more important. Joining me now to discuss this is the Minister assisting the Prime Minister and Cabinet and the Minister for the Public Service, Ben Morton from Canberra. Ben, thank you for your time. We've long talked about this issue being before various parliamentary inquiries into recent elections. It's always been there as a feature. We must have ID is the committee recommendation before people vote. Talked about, never implemented. You've got a bill in the parliament. It's now being debated. The opposition are very uncomfortable about supporting it. How are you? Will it pass?
Well, look, it needs to. This has been recommended by joint parliamentary committees into the electoral system after the last three federal elections. Its time has come. We're behind the rest of the world. European nations, Sweden, Belgium, France, the UK is introducing voter ID now, and we see this in the US. We need to have the strongest integrity in our electoral system. If you can get a parcel from a post office, but you need to show your ID, surely the important task of voting, the presentation of your credit card or your driver's licence or a whole range of forms of ID is the least we can ask for, to make sure that we can get rid of phrases like vote early, vote often, completely out of the Australian vocabulary.
We know in some of the federal seats they come down to 100 or less votes. We know of instances where people have voted, you know, well over 20 times, or reported to have voted over 20 times. Very hard to police, very hard to follow up. Why would anyone be opposed to making our system have more integrity?
Well, see, I find that very hard to work out. And the campaign from the Labor Party has just been unhinged, to be frank, Peter. There's been a whole range of claims against this. Let me give you an example. When we introduced this bill into the House of Representatives, where we presented the bill and the detail, the Labor Party hadn't seen it before then. But within 18 minutes, Tanya Plibersek was out there, the Deputy Leader of the Labor Party, saying that we were going to require people to show photo ID to go to the booth. Now, the details are of the bill that it's not just photo ID. It could be a credit card. It could be a bank statement. It could be a utility bill. It could be an Indigenous land council or native title document. But, of course, Labor wanted to get straight out there and kill off this bill. They've been out there this week. They have declared that if this bill passes, the first thing an Albanese government will do, the first thing will be to repeal this legislation. You know, I've got to feel sorry for Jim Chalmers, the Shadow Treasurer. They don't give him any questions in question time. And now he's just found out that the highest priority of an Albanese government, if they get elected, has got nothing to do with the economy, nothing to do with jobs and nothing to do with national security. In fact, if Labor get elected, what they're saying is that they're so scared they're going to face an election very quickly because of the instability of a Labor-Greens government, they've got to put electoral legislation in as their first order of business. Like, give me a break. There's something wrong here, Peter.
One of the criticisms levelled at you is that you're going to stop people voting, that somehow if they turn up and they haven't got the right bit of ID, they won't be allowed to cast their vote. But that's not true, is it?
It's certainly not, Peter. And you know me well. I've looked at how this is operated in Queensland. I've had a look at other proposals around the world. In fact, I would say that we will have the biggest suite of ID documents that are allowed for the showing of ID to vote. In fact, we have designed this in a way that will mean not one person will be turned away from a polling booth. If you don't have ID when you turn up, you will be able to say to your mate, look, I forgot my ID, can you attest to my identity? And as long as they've got their ID, they can say, yeah, that's Ben Morton. Now, failing that, I can do a declaration vote, which means I just fill in some details and they'll check off those details after the fact, but not one person will be turned away. And so we're hearing all sorts of mistruths in relation to what this bill will mean. I'm surprised and confronted by the level of mistruths that have been put out in relation to this. And, you know, we've put a lot of effort into increasing Indigenous enrolment in this country. And when we look in Australia, in Queensland, there's been the three most recent elections in Queensland. One of them had voter ID. It was that election that actually had the higher turnout than the two that didn't. And yet they are complaining that this is going to turn voters away. This is about voter suppression. Not at all.
Well, I've got to ask you about a scrappy couple of days in Parliament. I've said to people on radio today, you know, it's a hallmark of the end of the year. It's a hallmark of a pretty tough couple of years. Things do get scrappy at the end of the parliamentary year. But this is a lot of scrappiness. It's floor crossing. And I think the expected players in the Senate were out there on issues of vaccine mandate. That's been well known. But I think Bridget Archer was a real surprise today. You're a strategist before you're in the parliament. How concerned are you?
Well, look, I'm focused on these two bills. I'm focused on the voter ID bill, which has to pass this year if we're going to effectively put it in place before the next election. I've got another bill, which is about greater transparency in our political funding system, which will actually stop foreign money coming in to influence Australian elections. It will also make sure that organisations that are set up to divert money into political organisations can have transparency applied to them on the source of their donations. And I would say to the Senate, these bills are important to get in place and be passed this year, and I would encourage individual senators to support the government and support what they would like to see in the passage of these bills. Yeah, look, I don't think the Australian people are focused on what's happening in Parliament. I think they're focused on what's happening in their lives. That's what the point the Prime Minister was making in question time today. But, you know, the members of Parliament are free-thinking members of Parliament, and they're certainly looking at issues one by one. And look, that does look a bit untidy for people that watch politics day in, day out. But what matters is outcomes. And that's, I'm focused on the outcomes of my two bills, and I encourage members and senators to support them because they do need to pass.
Right, just before we go, where do you think Labor will be on religious discrimination legislation or protection, freedom of religion legislation that's coming today?
Well, look, they've been very quiet, and I think this is a very important piece of legislation. I think the Prime Minister, as you commented, spoke very, very well on it today in introducing it. We do need to make sure we can protect people of faith from discrimination, not to, and this bill makes sure that there is a shield from discrimination, not a sword where you can actually discriminate against others. I think Michaelia Cash has got the balance completely right on this, and I congratulate her for the work and the consultations that she's done. Labor have been quiet. I don't think this is a bill that the Australian people want to see politics played upon. I'm hoping that quietness means that they are working through their party processes a way in which they can support this bill, because I think it's an important bill, and particularly in Western Australia. I have many in my electorate of Tangney. People of very many different faiths. I attend there, whether mm-hmm. they be Hindu churches or Sikh temples, whether they be you know, Pentecostal or Anglican or Catholic churches. They deserve a freedom to believe in their religious tenets, and this bill will protect that.
All right, Ben Morton, Minister Morton, thank you for your time.
Pleasure. Always good to be with you, Peter.